Ay, ay, ay. Seriously, I watched a YouTube video of this guy. I think he had like 17,000 subscribers. KATS, that was his name. KATS, KATS. I remembered it. Wow. But yeah, he made some videos talking about how he regrets getting that tattoo pigmentation done on his hair. Now, I don't know his age. Based on the video I saw, I'm gonna guess like mid-20s. And he appeared to have zero hair on top. He what he calls like a botched job of the tattoo pigment. And in case you're not familiar, it means they literally get a tattoo needle and they like put in little black dots or whatever your hair color is supposed to be. And I mean, they even just frame your forehead. I mean, because like, even this, all of that is done. So then you just have to always shave your head. But the concept is it gives this illusion that you've actually got stubble growing in because you're really shaving it down to a 1.5 guard. That's kind of the concept, my understanding. And here in Nashville on I-65 going north, there is at least one billboard advertising this, and I always see it. It says something like from bald or from balding to cool or something. Now you're the guy with the low forehead, the Norwood one right here, but you're still buzzing it off, and now for the rest of your life, as long as you just shave off your actual hair, you're gonna look cool. You'll always have that. So imagine what that's implying. You're 60 years old and you've got this black stubble. Now, I know what we can say is like, well, yeah, well, when you're 60 years old, you're not gonna be looking that good anyway. I argue with you. You've seen my dad before. He's 60 years old, and he's lost a decent amount of hair, but he's cool. Everybody loves my dad. And many people have told me how handsome my dad is on both of my YouTube channels, the other one being Family Friendly Daddy Blog. So there's this whole concept that I'm all about aging with grace and, I don't know, just realism. I want to age with realism, which is why I'm a balding advocate. I'm fine with just going bald naturally and going along with it. But man, yeah, you're gonna be 40, you're gonna be 50, you're gonna be 60. And then it's gonna be really obvious that it's not real. Now, let me share this personal story with you. And I talk about this much more on my other channel, Family Friendly Daddy Blog, which focuses on my ethnic background and DNA test. But I've said before on this channel, my grandmother, she passed away last year. She was Mexican. She was 100% Mexican. Her parents were born in Mexico. Michoacan, I think is how you say it. I don't know. And so her older brother came to visit before she passed away and before she really became bedridden. And they were just like brother and sister. They were having fun. They were talking. And I was watching these two people in their 80s. And here's the thing with him. His and I think yeah, I guess he's still alive. But he lives in Buffalo, New York. So that was one of the few times I've seen him in my life. But if I were to guess his actual Norwood status is probably five. Like I think he still might have had still kind of a bridge going on, but it was just so there just really wasn't anything there. And there's this all of this definitely was completely gone. And not to mention he was in his 80s or pushing his 80s. And so what he did, I'm not making this up. He got black shoe polish and he just like painted on his hair. I'm not making this up because he stayed with my parents. And I happened to be there that weekend, from out of town. And I saw he had like a brush and then he had like Kiwi, like brand black shoe polish. Like, so I saw what he used to do it with. And then I'd see him and like, it's very obvious when you see a man that old and he just got this black paint on his hair. Now, I understand that the tattoo pigment thing's probably not looking that bad, but still, it's not gonna look realistic as you age. Plus, it doesn't take away the shine of your head. Like when you go Bruce Willis, like that's more natural to have the shine on that. That's fine. But when you have this black stubble, but then it shines that much, like if you have some stubble that's natural, it's going to, downtone the shine. So I say all this, and anyway, check out his channel, KATS. He's never heard of me, and he never will. He's a big deal. I'm not. But check out his channel, see what you think about it. And I guess he went through the process of actually getting tattoo laser removal to make it all go away. Now, that's a horror story of this tattoo pigment. Let's talk about this more. Is there anybody out there who either has had this done or knows somebody who had it done and was actually pleased with the results? I mean, because I know in my videos for all this time, I always say, look, I'm a balding advocate. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go bald and embrace it. But for a lot of you, you got to do what's right for you and your identity. So get the hair transplant, get the propecia, get the tattoo pigment. I always say that, don't I? I want to make it fair for everyone. But after watching this video, I became really skeptical of it. Do what's right for you. But is there anybody out there who actually says, you know what? I specifically, personally think it's a good thing to get this hair tattoo thing on your head. I've got so much skepticism. Again, I don't judge anyone for doing it, but I just want to become enlightened. Teach me more about this and how it's not so much of a just, like, I just can't see a lot of ways this could go well, especially as you age and start graying, you know? Like, I don't really have much gray hair at all. And when I do, I pluck it. But at some point, this isn't going to be this color. And everyone's going to know it's not real. Imagine being a 60-year-old man with this black illusion that you've got a buzz cut and all black hair. Okay, help me through this. Comments, do it.